motor has been installed now. There's the motor. This is the camera is located at the air intake, one of the air intakes of the central fuselage, and now we're going to test the motor and all the wiring. 3, 2, 1, start. Is there any thrust getting produced? Yeah, I think so. Let's speed it up. Yeah. Yep. It is. A lot of thrust. Yeah, definitely lot of thrust. Whoa, lot of thrust. Coming forward, the whole fuselage is moving. Nice, so this has a lot of power, that's for sure. It moved the whole fuselage. So, yep. Second thrust test complete, and the wiring is finally proper. Electronic speed controller of 80 amps and 6S capacity, which is 22.2 volts, is installed. The C rating of the batteries, graphene induced batteries I'm using, is 40C, which should be approximately somewhere 80-ish amps. Yeah, somewhere in the area of 80 to 88 amps. That's 40C rating. And I am going to be using two batteries in the jet. I'll keep two batteries in series. So per battery voltage is 11.1 volt, 2 amps. And in series, it will be 22.2 volts, 2 amps. So I'm going to increase the voltage. The ampere stays the same. And that should give me about 120 amps of peak current, and the jet efflux rate should increase by factor of 2, and the thrust of the total with the thrust tube, I've also installed a thrust tube at the exhaust, so the total thrust out of this system should be approximately 2 to 2.5 kilograms. That should be more than enough to fly this plane with all the weight, two batteries. These batteries are, well, heavy batteries. You're not average AA batteries. Heavy batteries these are. But for their competition, like other LiPo batteries are heavier. These are graphene induced orange LiPo batteries. So they should give better peak current and good discharge rate. Although the flight time would be pretty less, maybe 10 minutes, or it could be even less, it could be 5 minutes too. So it depends on how I fly it. If I keep flying it at 100% throttle, I am going to get 5 to 8 minutes of flight. At minimum 30 to 40% throttle, which I should be, which I think it should be enough for the jet to take off. If I fly it at that throttle speed, it would give me 10 to 15 minutes, but not more. But this jet is not built for duration flight, it's built for speed. So should go more than 70-80 kilometers per hour. It should reach, theoretically it should reach more than 100 kilometers per hour, But let's see, I have not exactly calculated each and every component's weight here. So I can only find the speed of this by keeping a GPS module inside, which I have. And then let's see what's the actual speed of the aircraft when it's made. Thanks for watching.